Everybody, whenever you'll join, welcome to Bible Study with Titoluwa again on Tito the Writer's page, because we're trying to build awareness for Bible Study with Titoluwa. Hi everybody, hello, what's going on? Hi Lord. Hi, welcome to Bible Study with Titoluwa. Today we study Galatians 6. Hi everyone. How has your week been so far? How was your weekend? Give me gist, what's going on? Good evening. Hi Dorsey, hi Oyinkosola, hi Miss Lubes, hello, what's going on? I know those people who are going to be Bible study to do, they will complain now, but the thing is we're trying to build awareness for Bible study to do. We're trying to build awareness for that platform. I don't want to be teaching to, don't let me pretend, teaching to 70 people when we have 10,000 people. No. Hi, if you are in Nigeria, if you're in Lagos, have you registered for the healing party?
Hallelujah.
Have you registered? Would you be streamed online?
Yes. One more time. Let me know.
I've answered that question maybe 100 times. It will be streamed. I'm talking to those that are not, that are physical.
Say hallelujah. Ooh. Hallelujah.
If you have not registered, register. I would not want you to miss it. Register. Send to your friends. There's healing party Ghana. The healing party in Ghana, by God's grace, is November.
Are you ready now?
I can't go live on both platforms.
Now, can you do me a favor? Can you just lift up your hands and celebrate the Lamb?
It'll be very soon, but I can't do that.
Yet. Celebrate the Lamb.
All the things people ask me, I have to realize that people have been screaming about Mixlr. People have been talking about Mixlr, for instance. I went on Mixlr. I'm supposed to pay. So all this pay, something. My question to you is, do you realize that they do pay for these things? I don't know if you get. Okay? Ah. Who is asking me for where the link is to register? It's on my bio. It's in my bio. The link is in my bio. Or you can just check any of my captions. You see it. So I've been gymming, and it's not free. Mixlr is not free. They want to make their money now. Mixlr is no more free. To open a channel is $9 per month. You people, you have to live there. You see these Konkolo children. If I go outside now, they will run. No problem, Mikachin, it's fine. That's why I told you that it's in my bio. It's okay. Anyway, welcome to Bible Study with Titoluwa. You are welcome. I'm so glad that you're here today. There's a page called Bible Study with Titoluwa. We've done that, Damsel Ella. I can't be stressing. I've sent links. TikTok has shut down pages. They keep coming back up and people keep falling victim for it. So that's not on me. I can't tell my ministry to fighting fakers. At this point, you people should have sense. This is 2024. It's the same line. They are not even using new lines. They are using the same lines. We're wrapping up Galatians, Book of Galatians, this today. If you are here and your ring light is... You know that I'm using ring light before. Don't you know that busy ring light? Galatians 6:1-18. So my goal here today is that we should finish in 1 hour, okay, or less. All right, Father, thank you for the revelation of your word. We thank you for your presence, oh God, that is undeniably felt here. Thank you, Father, for your presence. Thank you for your peace. Thank you for the revelation of Jesus. Thank you because the entrance of your word gives light and it gives understanding to the simple. We ask in the name of Jesus that, Father, there be healing, signs, and wonders taking place as we find Jesus even in this chapter. And as the Jesus that we find helps us to practicalize what we see, so that what we see in this scripture, so that we can live even better lives in him in the name of Jesus. We ask that your presence be undeniably felt. In Jesus' name we have prayed, and the saints of God say, Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Galatians 6, let me start from, if you're new here, we read various translations of the Bible. This is because English is not the primary language of the Bible, so we would have like a broader idea, scope, aspect of the scriptures that we're studying. Okay, stand fast therefore in the, okay, no, this is 5. Let's just stand fast. I want us to jump again now. Hey, God. How many of us enjoyed Galatians 5? I've not gotten over that Bible study. That was a powerful one, right? It was powerful. Brethren, if a man is overtaking in any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness, considering yourself, lest you also be tempted. One of the things that I've learned in life is to never say never. Because you see, that never that you said, it will so never you. There were things that I used to judge as a teenager that I can't judge now. I mean, I'm not saying that it's not wrong, but I have better compassion the more I grow older. And this reminds me of the scripture of the story of the woman that was caught in the act of adultery. When Jesus said, let he that is without sin cast the first stone, the Bible says that they started to leave from the eldest to the youngest. So the elder ones immediately left because they are more aware. They are more aware of their weakness, okay? The elders left first because they understood a bit more that life is not exactly a never something. I don't know if you had said that I will never do this again. Some people even go on a limb and say, Father, if I ever do this again, kill me. And then you realize that somewhere, somehow, somewhere, you just do this very same thing. How many of you, like me, have judged a certain thing? Glory to God. You have condemned it. You have decried it. You have talked about it. You have preached against it. That's your ministry. I remember before I went to do my NYSC, if you're not Nigerian, trust me, you're not missing anything. It's just a program, a one-year program where you serve the nation. And I preached before that time on Facebook. I had quite a huge following. And I had preached so much and loudly about sex before marriage. I preached against it, about cohabiting. I talked about it. I had insulted people. If you are sleeping with your boyfriend, you'd be ashamed of yourself. Pack your bag to hell. I was hot. And religious people were clapping for me like, yes, yes, yes. What they did not tell me is that usually when you are preaching about something a lot, God bless you. When you are preaching about something a lot, you are asking yourself to be tempted in that regard because you are speaking as an authority. Now, authorities are not really about those who speak about it. No, they are those who have scars from it. What makes a general is not years in service. What makes a true general is the number of scars in his body. I don't know if you understand what I just said. Even Jesus, before he became the savior of the world, he had to live in this flesh first. I hope you understand. He had to live there. And that's why he doesn't condemn us. Because even though he was God, he felt it. The Bible says, for we do not have a high priest that is not unmoved by our what? Our infirmities. Baba knows exactly how the shoe pinches. If Jesus were to preach, that is why when they brought the woman who was caught a so pelende, I wanted it to be quiet and gentle. He said, but it's going, okay? When they brought the woman who was caught in adultery, what did he give her? The gift of the pardon. He forgave her first because he's aware. He knew. He ate sitanda. I hope you realize that. It's not as if they said she was committing adultery. It's not as if it was a rumor. It's not as if, okay, they brought her from the act as per from the, they brought her from there and they took her to Jesus. She was a married woman who was sleeping with another man and they brought her to the Holy of Holies because Jesus, Etasika, is the carrier of the Holy of Holies. They brought her to the mercy seat. They brought her to the God who cannot be touched by sin. And yet, in his nature, he wrote on the ground and said, let he who is without sin cast the first stone, because he knows when I, who didn't know, was judging those who had never been there. That's why you cannot, it takes somebody who has dealt with masturbation and pornography to be able to preach to someone that do a toast. Do you get what I'm saying? To be able to preach to someone who is dealing with pornography and masturbation. And let me go on one step further and say, sometimes religion makes you pretend like you've forgotten. Religion gives you selective amnesia. You forget that you were once there. You forget that you once battled the same thing. And then when it's time you are presented with the same issue, you stand there in your sanctimonious glory and you look from the tip of your nose and you begin to castigate people because grace found you. Let me submit to you one more time. If your brethren is taken by a fault, what you should do is that the same grace, kapatousi, the same comfort that you received is the same comfort that you should use to comfort them. 2 Corinthians 1, he says, blessed be God, the God of all comfort, who comforts us with all manner of comfort, so that we may comfort others with the same comfort which we have received. I hope you are listening to me. The grace you receive is not for you alone. It's so that when it comes around you, you are able to say, I've been there before, but grace helped me. And if I was bitten by the venom, I have the serum. You are selfish to think that God saved you from that mistake, that mishap, that addiction, that habit, so that you can continue to pretend like you were holy, so that you can listen to me. I'm not saying that you should glorify the sin. I'm not saying that you should begin to permit nonsense. No, but I'm saying that you should realize that you didn't keep yourself, but that it was Christ that kept you. That's what I'm saying. And this is not talking about those preaching heresy. From Galatians 1 to almost Galatians 5, Apostle Paul was calling those preaching nonsense, preaching against the freedom that we have. So this is not because he fell off out of grace. No. This is about mistakes. Don't stop saying that. It can never be me. Shut up. See, with all humility that I can muster, shut up. Pray for the person. Pray for them. Don't be seen amongst people, no member of my tribe, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. That's right. I bring the witness of heaven into what I'm about to say. No member of this tribe will be part of people that will be sharing the links of a pastor who fell, or a pastor who made a mistake, or a leader, or a minister. Stop it. That's not the gospel. If you don't have their number, listen to me, you can't correct them. If you've never commended them,
you don't have the right to condemn them. The God that called them, he knew of their weaknesses before he called them. In fact, during the time he called them, he knew. He knows what he's doing. Pray for now. There are some that are clear. And see, the thing is, assuming all pastors, and I say this because it's painful, assuming they know that if I make mistake, my other pastors will cover me, will carry me. My members will cover me, will carry me. They will not be dying inside. They will know that, member, come and save me, oh. There is this lady that has been calling and calling. It's red alert, oh. They'll be able to open their mouth and open and say, help me. But because everybody's pretending, we are all pretending to be strong, pretending as if it's not the same flesh that me and you we have. Let's keep pretending. Let's keep. If I see any member do my tribe member, let me. Can I promise you, your original charger will burn. Your favorite shirt, iron will burn it. Ma, what do you think about Pastor this? What do you think about Bishop T.D. Jakes? What I think that Jesus is Lord. That's what I think. Think. Is it thinking? I think it. It's not even think. I think that Jesus, he died for me. That's what I think. He died as me. when he was buried, I was buried with him. When he resurrected, I resurrected in him. Now I am seated in Christ. That's what, if you ask me what I think. Hello. He said, you are spiritual. You who are spiritual, restore such a one in a spirit of gentleness. Considering yourself, think about yourself, think about your life. Considering yourself, lest you also be tempted. One of the greatest ways to assure your temptation is to start judging others. In fact, it works like speed of light. If you want to know the next temptation you will have, study the people you've been judging. I can never wear that kind of clothes. You just suddenly have desire for it. You would have worn it. Keep quiet. Preach the gospel. Preach the gospel. That's what you should preach. Ma, excuse me, ma. Don't excuse me, mommy. The gospel. If it's not the gospel, move on. Verse 2. Bear one another's burdens and so fulfill the law. What's the law of Christ? Love. How do you bear one on another's burdens? Pray. See, I know that a lot of Christians don't pray for others because you are too, you gossip too easily. It's too fast for you to gossip. If I know that I'm praying for this brother about this thing and he now makes a mistake, I'm too invested spiritually in that thing to gossip about it. If you can gossip, you can evangelize. It's just wrong information that you know how to dispense. And that's what religion does. Let's pray for Brother Micah. Brother Micah, you know, let's pray for him. Let's pray for him more. Brother Micah and Sister Sarah, they've been doing wallyward day. They've been entering and becoming out. You know, I smell. You're always smelling rubbish. A brother and a sister cannot be played. Do you know how many nonsense? And it's Christians. It's Christians. Do you know that most of my friends that are not pastors, they are not spiritual people, they look at my brother and I, Pastor Noble and I, and they're like, oh, your artist, your brother, how's your brother? This, that. It is Christians. And so how does your husband cope? Cope with what? With his brother? Always smelling. I'm just thinking. I'll be uncomfortable. Carry your discomfort away from my side. I did not marry a lily-livered man. I'm just thinking. Focus on the gospel. You will not focus. I'm just thinking. Take it what? So God will not say, these two people that I have an agenda for both of them. They have a purpose together to fulfill. Must you marry everybody you are connected to their kin? Oh God. Bear one another's burdens. So instead of you to Pray. And Father, thank you for Toluwa and Pastor Nobuji. Thank you. That's what you should do. That's how I know that you are vested. No, no. Your own is to be I want Tinkerbell. I'm just thinking, your husband, leave that handsome man alone. Can you please leave my husband alone? Carry your rubbish thinking away from me. Bear one another's burdens and so fulfill the law of Christ. Pray. 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 You've watched Nollywood movie. Is life Nollywood? Pray for people. You see people doing. Do you know what? Something that touched me today. Somebody says, because when we're the last trip Pastor Noble and I went for, we had to come down. This was 5 a.m. and there was mad traffic to the airport. We were 3 minutes away and we paid 5,000 naira. That's how much the bike men were, because there was no other option. And I just wrote it on my status. Somebody sent me the money today. That she saw. Is that bear one another's burden? Is that not bearing burden? No, no. Is that not bearing burden? I see the way you respond to Pastor JJ. Who is that Pastor JJ? Who is that? He is my brother. And if you have a problem with us, you are incestuous in your mind. You are incestuous. Every Bible study, you will call Pastor JJ. Okay, we are dating. Now faint. Because some of you need to be shocked with things like that. Okay, we are dating. Carry us to God. Carry us to Jesus. See if he will not ask you to cast the first stone. Very, very rubbish mind. Someone said they are brother and sister. You are saying, brother. And you are a Christian. And you are a Christian. And you are a Christian. That's the problem with religion. You focus on another person's weakness, thinking that focusing on their weakness cleans your own weakness. It's a lie. Your own is there. It's staring in the face. Stop this unne- no, 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 no. Let's, the gospel. I told somebody before, I said, the way you are asking about me and Pastor Nobu, you will soon ask about me and Marjorie. She's a woman. You will soon ask me that you sit on her lap, she sits on your lap, you do this one, you do that one. I said, as I'm like this, I've dated the word man, woman, goat, animal, dog. I'm in a dating. But as long as the gospel is coming, Sha, you think God will sit down somewhere and allow the person that is preaching his gospel to be called into shame? You joke. Verse 3, for if anyone thinks himself to be something when he is nothing, he deceives himself. Because he's a lie, where all of us are nothing. We are living in this flesh together. Are we not living in this flesh together? Somebody, this person is always too angry. You know that when you are driving in your tinted car, you know how many times you've gotten tempted into offense. You know. Stop lying now. We did this in Ephesians. We are facing it again. Stop lying. Stop thinking yourself as something when you are nothing. That is religion is so focused on dressing a dead man. You know that you yourself, you are tempted. Do you know that some people that are dealing with pornography, they are the most castigating people that are dealing with masturbation and pornography the most. They are the ones with the clearest rhetoric. Some people they've not prayed in a long time. They are the ones doing full expose of why Christians are not praying. Can you stop lying? Maybe the gospel will proliferate more. We die to flesh and we allow the gospel to actually take the shine. Maybe. You see, before I came for this program, you know, healing party, I've been on the mountain. Which mountain? Moshe Shemu Gari. I just took Gari now. Which mountain? Who mountain? When he went to the cross. Why am I going for any mountain? Tito, you have been talking about how you've been struggling with these finances too much. You like lies. That's why there's racketeering in the church. Yes, I will tell them that it's not easy. It's not easy. To do a free program is not easy. That you've been talking about how you mean, let's just avoid what? The person that started telling me to avoid is 1 naira I did not see. You prefer those that will come and say, no, somebody just gave me 1 billion. And you know. And I see, you're fasting. I know that for healing party, you are fasting for 42 days. Is it my power I'm going to use to heal people? Am I the one that died for them? God, I mean. You did not see that it's about the gospel. You didn't see that one there. What's my concern? Eh? What's my concern there? My own is to be a vessel. What's the... You're on the mountain. And it's so many people that have been on mountains. I've worked with various pastors. Let me, Tito, leave it. Leave it. Just move on. For if anyone thinks it's... Even if you are a pastor, you are nothing. That's why I tell people, don't, everybody is your mentee. If you're putting yourself in a place where you can't make a mistake. You can't, nothing. Yes, Pastor JJ, all of us are acting, pretenders. Diary of a Niger Girl posted how she's tired of the Lagos Eat social scene. The Eat scene, IT, means like the happening scene, like people that are making things happen. Maybe in the media industry and all of that. Just, and some of them, their social climbers also involved. And in the comments, I wrote, it will now shock you when it is the religious eating. And somebody that I love her, we just disagreed, but it just showed me that this is how people think. And she's like, Tito, I don't think we should be the people that will be talking down on religion. I said, you should be more worried that a lot of people are agreeing that religious eatings are worse. That should affect you more than you coming to tell me. It's just like saying, my mom offended me. She poured acid on me. And I'm like, oh, don't talk about your mom like that. Excuse me. I think you should be more worried. But that's what religion is about. No. What happens inside the house stays in the house. You will die there. Open the window. Let the smell of the stench get out. Why should religious gatherings be more? Why are we more stuck up there? I first told her, I said, I don't belong to any religion. That's why I said religious gathering. She said, then I now schooled her. She didn't have anything to say. You should be more ashamed that even the Christian religion, they are packing that their eyes, even worse. Don't you feel like that is more embarrassing? Because everybody's, we're all pretending. We're all pretending. After we're not done with that, everybody's going back to cry, to be frustrated. When we all of us could stay together and maybe everybody should say, I'm going through this, and we should be able to keep it to ourselves. Let's keep it. Let's not talk down. It's a horrible life. Horrible behavior. That's why people are shocked that it hugged me. I'm always looking at them now. So who should I hug? Myself? Because some people will get them. No, what? But let each one examine his own work, and then he will have rejoicing in himself alone, not in another. Let me read this in verse 4. 6 verse 4 in Good News. You should each judge your own conduct. If it is good, then you can be proud of what you yourself has done without having to compare it with what someone else has done. This horrible comparison. I want to be able to pray and be holy and be, you know, pious like Pastor Theophilus Sunday. My God. Then we saw glory in this world. Stop comparing yourself to other people. You don't know what's going on. Stop it. You just focus on your journey with God. Stop going. This pastor said it faster. If I can just be, you are not any. Stop it. We read it in Galatians 3:27. It says, for as many of you are baptized into Christ, you have put on Christ. Christ is your clothes. Stop comparing yourself with people. You don't know what's going on with their lives. I want to be, if I can just be like Tito, you don't know what Tito is dealing with. You don't know, even if she's not dealing with anything, who will be your own name? Stop this comparison where you are comparing yourself with somebody's highlights reel. You look at Tiwa Savage. Look at Tiwa Savage. The madam had a sex tape. It was news. She made money out of it, turned it into song. We forgot. But in us. How can you have this? And you know you are coming from your boyfriend's house. You are tweeting from your married man boyfriend's house. And you are casting another person. Move on. It's not you they should find in the dark comment section. Move on. We will not talk. He said, no, we should not bring down religion. No, no, let's bring down religion. Let's drag it. Because the veil that God himself tore from top to bottom, religion is sewing it back. Let's tear it, oh. Let's tear it. Bloody hypocrisy of a thing. I told you, I can't believe you will share that on social media. I said it's on YouTube. It's on YouTube. But there is no secret I want to come out now. That is not on YouTube. It's on YouTube. Who was perfect? Who? Who is the perfect person? Tito, I want to be like you. May you not be like me. Be yourself in God. Stop looking to be like another person. Do you know there's a song that is do to me like you did to Bishop Oyedepo. Do to me if God, why? Eh? Even Bishop will not pray that prayer for you. Do to me like you did to Arome. Do to me like why? They not put my name there. I say please remove me from that list. But let each one say, don't compare yourself with one another. Stop it. There's a scripture that says, if you compare yourself to another person, you're a fool because you are not thinking. You have God in your inside. You are trying to copy another person. You are an original. Stop trying so hard to be a copy. Verse 5, for each of you, in other words, each of you have your own life. Focus on that life. You've not finished adapting the gospel to your own life completely. You've not finished adapting the gospel to your own life. Eh? You are already comparing. They are not the standard. And this is why so many people cannot say, my pastor was wrong here. They can't, because you have turned them into your gods, your idols. No. No. And that's why people find it difficult to forgive their pastors if a mistake comes up, because you thought they were God. They are not God. They can't. In fact, forgive your pastors in advance. The closer you get to them, the more you will see their human side. You have to forgive them. They are human beings now. Human beings with spotlight on them and on their weaknesses. You must give them grace. And focus on your life. I can't. If I was a pastor, I can't. Shut up. So you shouldn't be answering them. You come and have over 100,000 followers and let them be looking into your life, the way you talk to your husband, the way you dress, the way you are friends with Pastor JJ and Pastor Nobuji and Pastor Lanre. Let them come and let people start to project their and see if you will not respond, or see if after 1 year you will still be standing. Let's stop pretending. All this pretense is irritating to you. I hate it. I hate phoniness. How are you? I'm strong. Okay, if you are strong, come and do the work. I'm not feeling too well, but I trust God. That is a real thing. All these lies. I'm strong. I'm rich in the Lord. I'm rich. And you don't have money. I say the reality and say, oh, but BUT cancels what you have said before. But I don't really have so much now, but I trust God to provide. Is that no better? I'm strong. I should come here and say, Healing Party has been fully funded. And we're still looking to pay. You just hear on Insta blog, popular Christian influencer did not pay. Abio, the way you want to, ma, this one that are going to gym, do you want to finish? I actually did a video telling people, see, there are times I'll be preaching like this. The entire church I'm preaching is turning in circles because no stamina. And for the journey, I need stamina. Then why should I explain myself to you, sir, in the first place? Some people cannot take half of what they are saying. If it's me, you're not listening. I won't even listen to trolls. You will have a troll page, trolling the troll. 6, you should each judge your own conduct. If it is good, then you can be proud of what you yourself has done without having to compare. Then verse 5, for each of you, sorry, I read 4 now. 5, for each of you have to carry your own load. It has, actually, it has. 6, if you are being taught the gospel.
Hey, numbers, excuse me, please pay attention to number six. So, listen to verse six. So I will not have any use. If you are being taught the gospel, you should share all the good things you have with your teacher. Let me read it in another time. You will hear what today. Sure, you will hear what. Verses 6. Galatians 6. It's not me. It's Bible. Let him who is taught the word share in all good things with her.
Glory to God.
Who teaches? Let's read in another translation. I just like the Bible. I don't know if you get it. I like Bible. Because my birthday is coming now. I don't want to hear. So thank you for all you do. Thank you for all you do for us. Verse 6. Whoever is being taught God's word should share the good things they have. Glory to God. That's the gospel. The gospel here is the gospel. With the one who is teaching them. Let's read another scripture. Another verse. Message. Is this message? Because I think I like message a lot. Message is quite, it gives me a little bit of versus where's my Bible now? What's going on? Don't thank me for all I do. No. Be very sure now. You who have been trained to a self-sufficient maturity. Tito, you've changed my life. Tito, your videos have changed the way I view my life. Tito, you saved me from suicide. Tito, you just... Good. That's good now. May 16 is coming and it's a Thursday. Oh, Jesus. Oh, God. Be very sure now, you who have been trained to a self-sufficient maturity, that you enter into a generous common life with those who have trained you, sharing all the good things that you have and experience. A queen was born. Major General. This is why some pastors actually suffer depression. If they will not tell you, I will tell you. I will keep the same energy. This is why some pastors suffer depression. This is why some pastors have moved to religion. It's not right, but this is what tempts them. Because they don't ask you for money. Because they don't trigger you. Because they don't scare you. You will hear the gospel and some of you are irresponsible with it. It's wrong. If you have a pastor who teaches you the gospel, something should come out of you to him at least monthly. Just so it could be, see, it can be 5K. It can be 2,000 naira. Put it on your bank app to your pastors. Let him know. Piflo shared one day. You see this becoming down. Stop it. Piflo shared one day that one December was very frustrating for him. You know why? Because only one person in the whole church, I was not in the church. Please remember, I had not joined at that time. It's not possible. Even people know it's impossible. It is impossible. He said that it was only one hamper. He had taught the entire year. He died for me. You are free. No generational curse. You know. December came. He got one hamper from a this is very depressing. Trust me. Forget. It is very depressing. Because this is our job. But I'm grateful for the kind of tribers I have. Do you know that at least 80% of what we have paid for the healing party were paid for by tribers? Another thing, Bible study, after Bible study, I've never asked you to. There's only people that say, where is the offering? I don't really disturb. But there are some people, immediately after Bible study, to send your account number. Some of them already, I will get an alert. So I'm actually grateful for the kind of tribers that I have. If Pastor Nobu, my husband, they're always like, Tito, you're always having money because your tribers. It's encouraging. As somebody said, Tito, money is still not complete. Okay, I'll be sending you money until, listen, some people's parents, the reason why some pastors' children are recalcitrant is because they see the way members use their parents without any form of gratitude. And they decide that we never. It's a horrible behavior. Horrible behavior.
You will see your pastor with one shoe that is bent. And he teaches the gospel. I like the way he analyzes the gospel. I like the way. Only to be asking, go to Mixlr, go to this, go to open a website. So make it free. So just demanding. Not we can't see you as a Macedonian church. Just demanding. The church does not have AC. This is not working. The fan is not good. They did not greet me well. They didn't smile at me. Pastor did not hug me today. Pastor, your own is just complaints. Federal Commission of Complaints. That's your own. You see, many of my friends that their parents are pastors, it is painful to them the way their lives are. For there's one I can tell you, he is paid today. His daddy is having a landmark birthday, and there's nothing. This is somebody that has labored in the gospel for 40 years. Nothing that the members are doing for him. You think he's okay? It is wrong. It's a wrong behavior. I will tell you the truth. The same way I screamed about honoring parents, it's the same way I will scream about honoring pastors. If they're not teaching you, leave the church. Go and look for a church where you can submit to. You can. Oh, Tito, that was powerful. On my birthday, Tito, you changed my life. You did this. Oto, I even trust my tribers. It's not you. Other people. Couldn't be you. Let's not frustrate them. Please, let's celebrate them. For some of you, I cannot celebrate. Why are you always posting people? Why are you always posting people? Is it the only one? Is it? Yes, yes, yes. He's the only one. He's the only one. Hey, you're always celebrating Pastor Nobu. Yes, yes. You will not frustrate my brother. You will not talk him. As some people go there, he used to do riffs before. Now, he's just doing tongues. I'm always there in the comment section. Immediate to just put people, align them back. You will have platform. Some of you, is the pastors. You have pastors. Is the people that have great following. That are your own, the ones you'll be celebrating. You'll be tagging them. Your pastor that does not have, maybe has 600 followers or 300 followers. You don't know how to celebrate him. Because he's not really, he's not, that's rubbish. Let me tell you now, that it's absolute nonsense. Let me quickly let you know. Let's move on. I hope it is clear. It's not right. Do not deceive yourselves. No one makes a fool of God. That is, it's a continuation of that. Give to your pastors or give to the person that is teaching you the gospel. Because we've used this scripture for various things. Last one, what is for? In context, he's talking about that about give to them. Said, do not deceive yourself. No one makes a fool of God. You will reap exactly what you plant. What you plant, not where you plant. I don't know if you get it. What you plant, not where you plant. Again, what you plant. So don't worry if you are not receiving from where you planted. Trust me. Sometimes you will receive from where you planted, but many times you will receive what you plant. You will receive it. You will receive. Trust me. But please don't use that for your pastor. Pastor, you don't worry, you will receive. You be that what you bring. You be the what you plant. You yourself don't use it to now say, pastor, don't worry, you will receive. What? No. If you plant in the field of your natural desires, from it you will gather the harvest of death. If you plant in the field of the spirit, from the spirit you will gather the harvest of eternal life. Some of you are sowing seeds. You should calm down. Don't worry, they're having fun now. It's not problem. They are hearing. You know, sometimes you give people drugs, but you give them with sweet. Do you understand? Don't worry, it's working. All right, so you people have you sow into what's that word now? Religion, and you keep wondering why you are receiving law. Is your life is not is where you are sowing? Check your soil. It's not every soil that you should plant into. Can I also go there? Because they teach you the gospel. Sow into the gospel. You take your stand in the gospel. You give to the gospel, so that you can know what you are receiving and reaping as well. Okay? Verse 9. So let us not become tired of doing good. For if we do not give up, the time will come when we will reap the harvest. This is my encouragement to everyone doing your posting videos, you're preaching the gospel, you're serving, you're from one thing or the other, you're just busy just helping and all of that. Don't worry. Just focus on God. Don't focus on this thing I said about my birthday. I'm not focused on that. Maximum, my husband always goes over and beyond. My brothers, my sisters, some tribals here, I trust them. So I'm not looking at you, right? But apart from all of that, God gives the best gifts. Oh God. God gives the best gifts. I say God gives the best gifts. He knows how to do it. Oh God. God actually, there's been a year where God gave me a gift almost every week in May. Yeah, it was every week. Every week I was getting amazing gifts. And I think it was NYC. So God knows how to give you gifts, okay? But that's not why you should focus on him. You focus on him because of what? You focus on Christ. You focus on doing the gospel, right? Doing good works is doing what you are led to do, right? By God. Not just doing anything because you want to get from God. No, you don't do this because you want to get from God. I don't come on Insta Live because I know on Bible Study Solua because I want... No, I come here because I want people to know the gospel, to be free from the shackles of religion. And how do they do that? Do I do that by preaching the gospel? So whatever you are doing, even if you are a doctor, focus on Jesus. You are a nurse, focus on Jesus. You are a teacher, focus on Jesus. Don't worry. Very soon, you will get your reward. 10. So then, as often as we have the chance, we should do good to everyone, especially those who belong to our family in the faith. Especially them. Give them preferential treatment. 11. See what big letters I make as I write to you now with my own hand. Paul is talking about the fact that he's the one that wrote the letter. It's his handwriting. The people who are trying to force you to be circumcised. You see that he has gone back there. That's how you know that it's not them he was talking about in verses 1 to like 4. That one called them out. Paul is not joking about those ones. But he's now saying here, he says, the people who have tried to force you to be circumcised are the ones who want to show off and boast about external matters. They do it, however, only so that they may not be persecuted for the cross of Christ. Let's read it in Message Translation, verses 12. He says, these people who are attempting to force the ways of circumcision on you have only one motive. They want an easy way to look good before others. You see, these people pleasing, it is the one that causes a lot of people to fall into religion, to deviate, to fall from grace. You want to be accepted by people. You want to do what people want. You want to preach messages that people would rather listen to. He says that what? They want an easy way to look before others, lacking the courage to live by a faith that shares Christ's suffering and death. I hope you know that. I always tell people, it's not easy to preach the gospel. It's not. This gospel, it's very easy to preach law. It's very easy to preach law. It's very easy to preach deeds. It's very easy to preach performance Christianity. That is, I don't have to think about it. It's easy. Grace, you will read a scripture and be searching for Jesus. Proper autotomio, proper exegesis, where you are allowing the Bible explain itself. So it is easy to come and add Jesus plus something, but to stick with it, and it is different to preach it. To live it also is totally different. It's not easy. So he says those people is a lie. They want to look good. Yes, they want to look good easily. Verses 13. All their talk about the law is gas. It's what I said. All they themselves don't keep the law. And they are highly selective in the in the laws they do observe. They only want you to be circumcised so they can boast of their success in recruiting you to their sides. That is contemptible. It's disgusting. If they should be ashamed of themselves. That's what Apostle Paul is talking about. They should be ashamed of themselves. Let me take it again. He said they're highly they don't observe the law. You think the people that are guardians of the law, you think they keep the law? The law cannot be kept. It is impossible for you to keep the law. So don't get tattooed. They are just choosing the laws that they are not a guilty party for. And some the ones that are even guilty, usually, have you seen a thief in a market beat a thief that was caught before? Now they are beating the pain them pass. Their own is more energetic. You know why? Because it's like, you want them to catch me? Verse 14. For my part, I am going to boast about nothing but the cross of our Master Jesus Christ. I don't care how you want to put it. I fasted 72 days before this conference. Is boasting. You are boasting. And you are taking the shine off the power of God that produces kingdom events. And you are making it about you. I prayed for 4 hours. I stayed in my room. I didn't step out. So because of that, there's undeniable power here. The reason there's undeniable power there, sir, is because of the gospel. Ma, it's because of the gospel. It's not about your fasting. It's not about your praying. Your praying and your fasting, your suffering is not a currency in the spirit. His suffering is. You boast about the cross and the cross alone. I gave. And that's why God is giving me. Stop it. You gave as a response to what he has given you, not as a trigger for what he will give you. He gave you everything on the cross. All things are now ready. I travailed. And that's where, once you start hearing that groanings, it's... Don't leave it. But the cross of our Master Jesus Christ, I boast of nothing. Because of that cross, I've been crucified in relation to the world, set free from the stifling atmosphere of pleasing others. Because of that cross, I've been crucified. I've died. Listen to me. Today, as I'm speaking, observe a mental funeral for people's opinions in your life. Observe, do proper funeral service. Sing him, and say, "Herein lies the body of me that used to want people's validations and opinions. Let it die. I've been crucified in relation to the world." Religion is bondage to be. Listen to me. Aya. Oh God. Observe a mental funeral for wanting people to validate or like you. People liking you is not the rent you pay to live in this world. His blood already paid the price. You don't need them to like you. That's his bonus. That's a bonus. Observe a mental funeral now. Let it go. Let it die. It's religious. It is performance based. It is deeds based. That's what he says, Galatians 2:20. He said, "I do not care to impress you that I am now righteous." He says, "I don't even care to impress God." You are still there trying. What will people say? That what? If you do not do it, people will say. If you do it, people will say. How about you do it? Do it! Do that thing God said you should do. As he told, I really love, you know, there's an artist around me. I want to manage, but he's a man. I'm a woman. What do people say? Leave him there. Let him suffer. Shoba. Just watching the way you carry personal beauty on your hair. Just wondering. Wondering what? He's a son of God. I'm a son of God. I have platform. I mean, the assignment is clear. I will not be wasting. What people say? They will say it. Is he not saying? After the last year, what will not happen? What will people do? You want to, you kill yourself. My sister is a much better. What will you? Well, they will say it. What will people say? You see this yoga thing? We will do 1 hour. Because I was still thinking about yoga today. I was stretching after I did shoulder work today. And so the man said I should stretch. So I did this stretch. And I did this one. And I put my hand up. And I did all of that. And I was like, these are some positions in yoga. I didn't think it was yoga. They were normal positions. I was stretching the muscles that I just worked. So this thing about all the poses in yoga, they belong. I don't know how to explain it. Some people worship jollof rice. To us, it's food. To them, they think it's their god. Snakes, killing their animals. Me, I still don't believe all those. You see, you and they will do entire videos of how God appeared to them. Which God? You see, yeah. When you were doing the yoga, were you thinking about a god? There, of which we know there's no power on in heaven, on earth, under the earth. I honestly started gym, Misha, so I'm not really joining the yoga thing. I'm not really, I like aerobics, energy. But when I was doing the stretch today, I said, it's looking like some yoga. I don't know, this prison yard that we are putting ourselves into. I'm like, free yourself, I beg. Free yourself. When you are doing yoga, play I Acknowledge You by Nobuji. It's a yoga kind of, I acknowledge you. Then check this one. I acknowledge you. I about that. maybe you should play that. I acknowledge you. One, I acknowledge you. Two, your prayer. maybe if you play that music, because it's not possible. I don't know. Do you get what I'm saying? I don't know if it's not possible for Pastor Nobu to be singing. God. Like. So, maybe that's the music you should play. I will tell Pastor Nobu to help us to do some yoga songs. Your presence is... Yeah, another position. I acknowledge... Tito, move on. You see, as Christians, sometimes we turn everything to... It's too... You are busy looking for demons, sha. You are just always looking for demon. What is going on? Look for Jesus now. I don't understand. Every position in yoga is a worship of a god. I've already got the open. The god does not have to say, the god cannot say, I'm stretching my body. Please. So I acknowledge you. Try it for yoga. It's gonna work, okay? It's gonna work. We have 2 minutes here. Let me see if I can take one more verse, then we start on the other one. But we're almost done. Because of that cross, I have been crucified in relation to the world, set free from the stifling atmosphere of pleasing others and fitting into the little patterns that they dictate. I hope you know that people, religion, they want you to prove to them, not to God. They almost don't care about your relationship with God. Your skirt is too short. Tattoo is not skinny. Earring, is that God? They don't want to know if you heard God yesterday. They don't want to know if you be. They don't want to know. What they want is that please me. And that's what Apostle Paul is saying. They want to satisfy their ego, their controlling instincts. That's what they want to deal with. Thank you, Pastor JJ. Religion requires your brain to always see Satan in everything. Do you know that there's a study called demonology? They say that the name of the, if you are in church and you know that sound when the mic is not in proper tune with the speaker and it does that, you know, that scratching sound. They say the name of the demon that is in charge of it is grooming. The day I heard it, I said, it's not only grooming. You don't like bridey. God, I beg. I'm telling you, there's a demon for everything. When there's, what are you looking for there? It's the church of Thyatira. Is in religion. Is in Revelation. He said they study the depths of Satan. the depths of Satan, you are there just studying darkness. The way you know original notes is by, fake notes is by studying original notes. That's how you do it. Don't wear tattoo. You don't like it. It's fine, but don't say that it's a sin. It's not a sin. Conscious sin. We'll continue in the next 3, 2.
If you know how I started the first live, I was a little bit tired, you know, but by just, and funny thing is, before I started the live, I said, HS, this is the first Bible study that I felt like I don't even want to do Bible study. I want to postpone it. And immediately I said, see, HS, I know that means you are taking over from verse 1. He took over. He collected the live from me. Welcome back, everybody. Hello. Hello. Galatians 6 from verse 1 to 18. We are currently in verses 14, 15. I'm using Message translation, so I cannot see 14 to 16, where we are. Observe a mental funeral for people's opinions of you. Observe it. Let it die. Let it go. It's not something you should be bothering yourself about anymore. If you make a mistake, and you move on. If so, I've said it. I told somebody. I say in this our culture, which as hypocritical as we are, Tiwa Savage can still be making money. She can still be a star. You cannot fault me for anything. You cannot fault me for some of the mothers. They will see the Tiwa Savage in plane. These same mothers that will judge her, they will take picture with her. I lie. Is it Tiwa Savage your mentor? What I'm saying is you are hypocritical. You is the one I'm talking about, not her. So I will not kill myself to please your hypocritical lies. My allegiance is to what? That Christ lives in my inside. And I should yield to the Christ that lives in my inside. And it's a journey, it's a process that, quite frankly, you can't perfect on this side of the divine. Why? Because we are limited by flesh. So it's a continuous dependence on Christ. Cut yourself some slack. You are a human being. Present continuous tense. Being. And you will continue to be a human being until you are a human that was. So, cut you. You will make mistakes. Don't let anybody put that lie on you. Perfection is an illusion. And it's a proud illusion. My associate is here. Susu, what are you doing here today? Hey, she's going to cause trouble in this line. She says, I saw Tiwa today. Oh, my hair pretty girl. Very nice girl. Observe a funeral. Observe a mental funeral for people's opinions of you. He said, I only boast in the cross. I don't boast in anything. I don't boast in anything else but the cross. I don't boast in my fasting. I don't boast in my saving. I don't boast in my... Because another pride in church now. You know, invest. You know, I invest. Now I invest. You know, I invest. That's how the wealth came. And we know that it's not... Even when you calculated the way you came into wealth, your investments did not really, really, really hit like that. It is the blessing that was manifesting through you. Calm down. Someone will not be saying, me too, I'm investing. It's not what, my friend. Don't let anybody pressure you. Just trust God. I'm not saying investment is bad. I'm saying we cannot boast in that. You can't boast in something that fluctuates. Clearly, you can't. Yeah, it's hard work. It's hard work. Which hard work? Do you want to work harder than the person that is carrying cement in the inside? I had a clip today. At least to the best minimum, you did not make the choice to come to this life as a human being. That was God's prerogative. He could have made you a lizard. Eh? You don't know? You don't know that I could have made a lizard? Come on, put your hands down. I fasted. I prayed.
you know, it's relationships. This is as a result of relationships. It's not, see, any Jesus plus nothing. Stop giving glory to any other thing but Jesus. It is Jesus plus nothing. Now, when you focus on Jesus, he will now give you other things. But you yourself will know that your source is Jesus. Not your, it's not a resource. It's the source. It's the source. Can't you see the central issue in all this? It is not what you and I do. Submit to circumcision, reject circumcision. It is what God is doing, and he's creating something totally new. A free life. A free life. A free, that's what he's saying. He said all these things that we're talking about, that's not the main goal. No, I've ratted out their motive, which is always check your motive. Why am I doing what I'm doing? And that's why I tell people that even if you make a mistake, you thought you heard God. And it was God that told me that. There was a day I made a mistake and I felt so bad. I was like, God, but I thought I heard you. He said, I know. Now, you've learned from the lesson from the mistake, right? But I will still cover and reward you because you honored the idea that you were submitting to. Man can't do that. Man will be saying, you disobeyed me. You didn't hear me. People preach God like that. You know people preach God like that? Like, because you made that mistake, God will just say, it's not my concern, it's a lie. Even Bible says, even if I make my bed in hell, he's there. He's there. So even if you make your mistake, he is right there with you there. So rest. 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 Am I the Holy Spirit? Hope Aries. What did the Holy Spirit tell you about this statue? You. Did he say go ahead and do it? You see, when you constantly look for should I do it, come and tell me if I should do it. Is it right or wrong? He's giving servants, not sons. Sons don't live by rules. Sons live by relationships. Sons don't live by rules. Sons live by relationship. It is servants that are ruled by regulations. And a lot of us in the body of Christ, we are comfortable being slaves. What do you think about earring? I'm literally wearing earring in the video. What do you think about earring? What do you think about anklets? What do you think about trousers? I think Jesus Christ is Lord. That's what I think. I think he died for me. I think when he was buried, I was buried with him. I think that forgiveness is right there in the song. I think that I'm free. I think that he has delivered me from the... That's what I think. Stop allowing God... What does God say? What does God say? What does God say about what? About what will not enter heaven? I hope you realize that this king will not enter heaven. Now, if you now carry... what's his name? And you drag on. Well, you, that's between you and the Holy Spirit. You are a son of your father first. Okam Emmanuel. You is your father. He's primarily your father. You are his beloved child. That is your position. Service is your disposition. That is, you are the favorite of your father. You have administrative skills. Your father has a multi-billion dollar company. You work in his company. Yes, you are his staff, but you are different from just common staff. Why? You have the DNA of the owner of the company. You see the kind of people I'm talking about. This Adama Ezenekwe. You can as well stroll out of this place. This is not your. I'm not your. You're not my audience now. You're not. You can as well stroll out. Who are you talking to saying, you can as well stroll out. As you stroll in, stroll back outside. We're serving as sons. Did you get that, Emmanuel? Did you get that? You are his son first, his child. You are his favorite. He loves you so much. Did you get that? He loves you so much. So when you understand that, you because you understand that now you serve, you do his job well, but you don't serve your dad in that sense. You serve the goal, you serve the mission. He moved from father, from master to father, and it's not just father, right? He's a beloved, you are his beloved son. Do you understand? Uh-huh. So you are serving his goal. So why does my father have this company? Your dad wants to maybe end poverty in the Middle East. So you serve that purpose. So what is God's agenda? Salvation. So you serve that purpose. You preach the gospel. You are the gospel. You insist on the gospel. You take your stand on the gospel. You talk about God's love. That is you serving your father's mission. But as a relationship, you are a son, a beloved son. Did you get that now? You are a beloved son. Oh, it's shocker. He said he will come here, come talk anyhow. This is not the kind of place for that. If you don't know how to be respectful, how to be polite, how to understand that your preference is not law, you will be walked out politely. It's not, don't use, oh, we are Christians, we should allow. No, you have sense. I'm not that kind of person. I don't tolerate, I have zero tolerance for bad behavior. If you don't like the way somebody preaches, you leave. I've said it before, you leave. It's not, you don't have to be there. You walk out. Not your child or whoever you think I am that you think you were comfortable to write that nonsense. Yeah, you're welcome, Emmanuel. All right, let's move on. So what did God give us? A free life. We are free. We are free. We are free. Can't you see? Okay, so all who walk by this standard, that's the standard of the true life. All who walk by this standard are the true Israel. Are the true Israel of God. Are you getting that? All who walk by... So Israel is no more a place. Just the same way Eden is no longer a place. Israel is a people. Are you? Israel is a people. So who are the people? Those who walk in the freedom that we have received in Christ. Did you get that? Let me see in Good News verses, I hope that's 16. As for those who follow this rule with their lives, may peace and mercy, that's Israel actually, Salem or Shalom, be with them. So you are God's peace and mercy on them. Israel is a people, it's no longer a place. The Israel of God, they are a people. All this Israel. The Israel that Jesus, is now tourist attraction. You can go there. I would go there if I have the opportunity to go there. I'll go there, check what they are talking about and all that. Fine. But don't say this is the what? That's past. Eden is no longer a place. Israel is no longer a place. Why? Because what used to make them special was the presence of God. That presence, you have it in your inside. So you are now the ark of God. Did you get that? You are now the ark. You are now the ark of God. Mercy seat. All of him is in your inside. Did you get that? All of the mercy seat is inside you. Verse 17. Quite frankly, I don't want to. If Emma Fejok Pami is. Ephesians, Galatians 6 verse 17. I did not know there was a scripture like Mafajokwami. Mafajokwami is don't weary me with long conversations. Don't tire me out. MFJPM. Mafajokwami verse 17. He said, quite frankly, I don't want to be bothered anymore. You people, you've stressed me by this dispute. I have far more important things to do. What? The serious living. The serious living of this faith. I bear in my body scars from my service to Jesus. So he's talking about how that see, I've addressed this whole issue of circumcision and all of that. I've told you that they are trying to take away your freedom and all that. Please, I don't talk about this again. Do you understand? So he's talking about from chapter 1 and all of that, right? He says, so he now says he wants to focus on more serious matters. What is the more serious matters? Right? It is the serious living of this faith. That's what it is. Verse 18, our last verse. May what our Master Jesus Christ gives freely be deeply and pesetos. Somebody say amen. May what our Master Jesus, our elder brother, Jesus Christ, gives freely. That is, he gives you freely, but he's praying. Because he knows that, see, the enemy can, do you know that let me quickly digress a bit. That Adam and Eve sold their birthright for what they already were. So in Genesis 1:26, the Bible says that, let us make man in our own image, after our own what? Likeness. In Genesis 3, verses, is it 6 or so? It says, the enemy says, do you know that if you eat this, that if you disobey God, you will become like God? So they sold their birthright for what they already were. Did you get that? Did you get that? So that's why he's saying, may what? And God gave them that identity freely. But because they didn't know, So what Paul is praying here is about the consciousness. That may you know that you've been given freely. And may it be deeply, that's may you own it. May it be deeply and personally yours. May you not trade your identity for anointing oil or communion or the shofar. Or pray out, it is already freely yours. That's why that prayer is very important and very deep. He has given it to you freely. So may it be deeply and personally yours, my friend. Oh, yes, that's yes and amen. Amen. I'm very happy we finished our second book of the Bible. We read Ephesians. Wow. It's been over a month since we started Bible study with Tutoluwa. We hit 10k followers on our original page. Please follow our page, because we'll soon go back to our page. All these numbers, I want to be seeing it on Bible study with Tutoluwa. So we've done two. So if you've joined for everything, congratulations, you've studied two books of the Bible, in-depth knowledge and all of that. Congratulations to you. We've also studied John 15, 1 to 6 and Genesis 27. So we are eating good. We are eating good. Leave mommy alone, I beg. You just know the truth. But just to tell her, mommy, I don't need it on my head. Especially if you are thinking. I save all the lives. All right, questions. So our next, I'm so excited for our next book of the Bible. It is Romans. Our next book of the Bible is Romans. And I'm just excited. I love that book of the Bible. Love it. Thank you, Adesoe. I appreciate it. I love it. So from Thursday, we begin Romans 1. Ken Grace, what is your opinion of monitoring spirits? It's not in my Bible. I've not seen it in my Bible. And I don't have an opinion of the enemy. The enemy is the enemy. He's defeated. He's falling. He's disarmed. He has no power and no authority of his own anymore. That's what I know. But I know Jesus. My opinion of Jesus is that he's the Lord of all. How do you apply the gospel to your marriage if your spouse is religious? You now have to be the Jesus he sees you, or she sees. You have to be the Jesus that person sees. It's not going to be easy, but so the idea is to yield. So when they start seeing results, and you are saying, you know, I didn't even think about it. It was the Holy Spirit. I don't want to hear about it. Oh, sorry. After you say, it's the Holy Spirit. I can't lie. If I tell you how I got it now, you tell me that you don't want to hear. Oh, yeah, tell me, it's the Holy Spirit, right? And then try your best to befriend your spouse out of religious conversations. But at the same time, you now be the somebody said it is secular, it's a secular belief when your theology does not play out in day-to-day life. That is, be the dispenser of the full power that you receive. Do you understand? So the light may be too bright, the way it comes from the transformer, but there's a step down that will be able to be used. I can use the fan, I can use my light, I can use, and it will not blow up. Why? Because there's a step down. So you'll be the circuit breaker in your house. Does that make sense to you? You'll be the circuit breaker, causing there to be so many questions, causing there to be life in your home. And then a lot of prayer. Well, not a lot of prayer, a lot of dependence on God. Just depend on God, right? A lot, just depend on God, a lot. I hope I've answered your question. Tito, please, what do you think about sinning with an intent to be forgiven by God? Like, you don't want to sin, but you go ahead to sin because you know God will forgive. Like, you don't want to sin. It's scattering you. An intent to think about sinning without an intent to be with an intent to be forgiven by God. Then in your explanation, you go like, you don't want to sin, but you go ahead to sin because you know God will forgive you after sinning. This is the act, right? This is the act, because the nature of sin is already has been taken away and has been dealt with. The Bible says, behold the Lamb of God that has taking away the other, has come take away the sin of the world. So Jesus has taken away the sin of the world. Okay. So this act is mystic. I think that's God's prerogative, but I don't think God is angry by that. This thing that you read is Romans 7:50. If you read it, you see Apostle Paul saying, the thing I don't want to do, I do. Whether it's deliberate or not, at the end of the day, you are not the one that forgives them. All, including that deliberate sin, is forgiven. How about that? There's no special award for sin. That, oh, this one is deliberate. This one is not deliberate. So because you are not deliberate, this one is lesser in... The wages of sin is death. Whether it's deliberate or it's not deliberate. The wages of sin. Romans 7. Okay, let's read it. So this is Apostle Paul after he became Apostle Paul. Not before. Not when he was... This is Apostle Paul dealing with urges, right? We'll read by... Read by, because... It's easy to put, the caveat of sinning. I mean, it's a baby behavior to say, because God will forgive me. But you just said you don't want to sin. I don't want to sin, but I end up sinning, is what you just said. Let's read this in NKJV. It says, for what I am doing, this is Apostle Paul, for what I am doing, I do not understand. How many of you are like that? I mean, I've been there before. For what I am doing, I do not understand. For what I want to do, that I do not practice. But what I hate, that I do. How many people, if you lie to me, how many people know this? How many people can relate? That which I don't want to do, I do. Because that's what it feels like. This is. I know it is wrong. I hate it, self. I hate it. That's what he's saying. I do. If then I do what I will not to do, that's what I don't want to do, I agree with the law that it is good. But now it is no longer I who do it. In fact, when I read this scripture the first time, I thought, who told Apostle Paul about my story? Romans 7:15, they know my story. That's how I felt. Because that will be me. I know that it is wrong. I can preach how wrong it is. I can preach. For some people, there are people that send me DMs, they tell me the theology, the rhema behind how masturbation is a sin. And they've been heavily masturbating for 20 years. Because studying about sin cannot save you from sin. It is focusing on Jesus that can save you from sin. And the truth is, because somebody now decided, turn now knows the gospel, And because the mind, because even when you don't know the gospel, when you think about what's the word now? When you think about sin, do you know that every sin starts with thought first? You decided to do it. In the moment you decided to do it. So all people that say, hey, but you now decide. No, no, no. Every sin, that's my brother right there. Hi, Ivy. Every sin starts with desires first. It began, it started there. You decided. So don't judge another person that now knows the gospel. That God will. At that point, he's struggling. So you still can't judge anybody. That's what we learned today. It will shock you now. This is Apostle Paul, not Saul of Tarsus. This is Apostle Paul. He says, for I know that in me, that is in my flesh, nothing good dwells. For to will is, that is to do, I want to do it, it's present with me. But how to perform what is good, I cannot find it. That's what he's saying. That is, I have the desire. If it's about desiring to do good, I score pass mark. I am there. If it is about the desire, 100%. He said, but how to now carry it out? I can't find it. He said, I do not find. He didn't even say, I don't know. He said, it's not available. The ability to carry out that good thing is not available. Then he repeats it again. 19. He said, for the good that I want to do, I do not do. But the evil that I don't want to do, that one I practice. He didn't say I do. I practice. That is, make a constant. He does it. Practice is different from do. Do is I do it. What? Romans 7 from verse 15. I mean verse 20 now. This is so that you can understand this sin. That everybody, sin is deliberate. Hell fire. Calm down. Apostle Paul is talking here that, see, when it comes to sin, is desire first. Okay? Now, this is it. Romans, sorry, please let me write it. Romans 7, 15 to 25. Romans 7, 15 to 25. So verse 20. Now, if I do what I do not want to do, listen to verse 20. If I do what I do not want to do, it is no longer it is no longer I who do it, but sin that dwells in me. Apostle Paul removed himself to it. He says, it's not me. I mean God. I ain't looking like I tried. And that's why I want to be tried. But you don't put that in trouble. I don't want to try by fire. I want to try by fire. It's not necessary. Go necessary, my dear. It says 21. I find then a law that evil is present with me. The one who wills to do good. Let me read it in Message. Message is pressing, but I'm coming. Are you getting blessed? Are you getting free by this? So that you stop putting yourself in unnecessary pressure. Okay? There are times you know you have the life of God in you. So you know when something is not right. You are aware. All this, I knew. And then I went ahead to do it. So it's a sin. Listen, you are aware. Every sin. Even children know when they lie. Do you know that children know? Do you know children know when they lie? Babies, who taught them? The nature of sin. The nature of sin. Come on, show me message. The nature of sin is in their inside. I will bite this Bible. Come on, open for me. So don't. That's why you don't focus on sin. You focus on Christ. Because if you keep focusing on sin, verses what now? Let me rush 17 to 20. But I need something more. For if I know the law but still can't keep it, and if the power of sin within me keeps sabotaging my best intentions, I obviously need help. So he didn't say, I'm intending, but I'm not doing it. So I should be cast into the ocean. No, he said, I need help. Because it's not. You don't deal with sin by deciding, Father, I decide. No. You don't do that. I realize that I don't have what it takes. I can will it. Are you seeing scripture? I can, that is, I can desire it, but I can't do it. I decide to do good, but I don't really do it. I decide not to do bad, but then I do it anyway. My decisions, such as they are, don't result in actions. Something has gone wrong deep within me and gets the better of me every time. 21. It happens so regularly that it is, this is what I say by practice. It happens so regularly that it is predictable. The moment I decide to do good, sin is there to trip me up. I truly delight in God's commands. But it is pretty obvious that not all of me joins in that delight. Part of me covertly rebel. And just when I least expect it, they take charge. They take charge. 24. I've tried everything. Alessua, somebody's asking for where they can send proposal. I've tried everything. And nothing helps. Ah! How many of you have been there? God! God! I've cried. God, I've prayed. God, I've fasted. God, I've decreed. I've done confession. I've prayed. I've decreed. I've prophesied. I've rested. I've done. God, I'm tired. That's what it says. I've tried everything. This masturbation, I've removed TV from my house. I've turned off my phone. I've done this. I've taken a walk. I've taken cold showers. I've done everything that I can do. But somehow, when I least expect it, they take charge. Ah, I can almost cry. Because this thing, many Christians are there, and many times they end up in suicide. Or the Christian suicide, they die to anything spiritual. I've done everything. Nothing helps, God. I've done everything. I've fasted, I've shared. Have you ever confessed a sin before? And you thought, okay, maybe if I confess. And the day you confess, you finish the confession. Bruh. God does this thing so you can know there's nothing to yourself except from Him. And I hope you know that with all this you're doing, He still cannot see it. God has selective amnesia regarding your sin. He has chosen not to see it. He has chosen not to know. Religion cannot convince Him. They've been trying. They try every time to convince God to see your sin. But He says, I've tried everything and nothing else. I'm at the end of my rope. Is there no one who can do anything for me? Isn't that the real question? Hey, I just read somebody's life. It looks like this is the Bible study. I've tried everything. I've tried Abba. I've called God Abba. I've called Him Elroy. I've called Him Yahweh. I've called Him Jehovah. I've called Him Shammah. I've done everything. I've given. I've tithed. I've knelt down. I've served. I'm dead. I think NKJV says, who will deliver me from this body of death? Because it feels like death when you know something is wrong. You know, but you still can't stop doing it. You know it is wrong. You are aware. I stopped being depressed. They told me I should listen to sermon. They told me I should read, I should dance. I've danced, but I'm still depressed. I still feel this heaviness. I still feel this tiredness. I still feel this fatigue. I'm just unyielding to life. I don't see why I should rejoice. I've told myself, rejoice, Tito, rejoice, but I'm depressed. I'm tired. 25. The answer. Thank God. Hey. Thank God. The answer is that Jesus Christ can and does. He acted to set things right in this life of contradictions where I want to serve God with all my heart and mind, but I'm pulled by the influence of sin to do something totally different. I wanted to die, but God. I wanted to lose my life, but God. I wanted to end it, but God. I was tired of my sin, and I just felt like there's nothing else in this Christianity for me, but God. I was beat down, but God. I was quartered to disgrace, but God. It was almost half past shame, but God. I lost myself in this sin, but God. I kept masturbating, and in the masturbation, I would be crying, but God, but God, but eto sendi kaparindo shita, but God, but God, I didn't want to desire flesh anymore, but God, I, but God, but God, but God, I don't know if you can feel the power of, but God, the answer. Thank God is that Jesus Christ. If the weight of the burden is too heavy for only you to bear, you can't save yourself. If you could save yourself, Jesus wouldn't have had to die. But the answer is not you. It's not I will pray more. It's not I will fast more. It's not. It is but God. Thank God for Jesus Christ. He can. And he does. It's not that he can and then he won't. No, he can and he does. He can and he does. That is, he does. He constantly, deliberately, intentionally lives God's life through you. Condemnation is not of God. Look at the next scripture. Are you ready for the next scripture? This is coming right from, you understood? What is the next scripture? Let me read it in NKJV. Romans 8:1. Coming from that story that I just read, from Romans 7 verse 15 to 25, where Apostle Paul was talking about how he has been struggling with a particular sin, the thing he wants to do, he will not do. Is that one that he doesn't want to do that he will do? And he kept struggling, and he kept struggling, and he kept struggling. And then he says, but God, there was no point that he said, I've now changed. He just said, Christ takes it away from me. That is, the responsibility is no longer on me, it's on Christ. What is the next scripture after that? It go pande shote, rababande siteya. There is therefore, that is, even and despite that, because I'm in Christ, I'm not condemned. There is therefore now no condemnation for them that are in Christ Jesus. The original translation stops there. It was people that added who do not walk according to the flesh. But let me help you. That is describing those who are in Christ Jesus. This other line is not based on your deeds. There is therefore, as long as your location and your habitation is in Christ, because you are in the flesh, you may still be suffering with the one I want to do, I don't do, whatever. But because you are now identified with the toga of Christ, there is therefore now no condemnation. I hope that's answered your question. There's no part of salvation that has to do with you. No. God never uses condemnation on his children. Never. So if you feel condemnation, it's not of God. Oh God. Ah.
But God. I've been through some things, but God. Left to me, I would have packed my bags and walked out, but God. I've seen some, but God. But God. I will not choose me. As in, even me, I will not choose me. But Jesus, but God. Go back and read Romans 7 from verse 15 to 25 and stop at Romans 8, verse 1. But God. But God. But God. I would have drowned, but God. I would have lost my way, but God. I would have given up, but God. They won't go about get me. They would have, they forget me, but God. He planned in advance, but God. I would have lost faith, but God. In fact, I lost faith, but God. I would have been condemned. Condemned, but God. Ah! Hey, Jesus. God said, I should tell some of you here, you will not be put to shame. You will not be put to shame. You will not be put to shame. He says, I've put my hand on you. I'm responsible for you. For you to be put to shame is for them to insult me, and I will not agree. You will not be put to shame. While I'm covering you, I'll be building you. I'll be washing you. I'll be cleansing you. I'll be healing you. I'll be freeing you. But you will not be put to shame, for I do not reveal the secrets of my children. You will not be put to shame. Oh, but God. How do I focus on Christ? Please give practical ways. Listen to Jesus revealing sermons. Listen to Jesus revealing sermons. That's how. We do not boast. How does someone know that he or she is loved by God, or he or she loves God? You don't boast on how much you love God. You boast on, you rest on how much he loves you. So how you know is by how much you know that he loves you. I'm taking the last question because I can't explain the motive of what I did not know. What is this? I cannot explain the motive of what I did not know. Do you understand? Please, Ma, can you explain? I'm not the actual motive for oil and mantle. For those people that used to do it, I don't know what they need it for. Okay, I'm going. See you guys on Bible study days. Usually, just check the Bible study page. On the bio, it's right there. Bible studies hold Mondays and Thursdays, 7 p.m. Please follow our page, Bible Study Tutoluwa. And at that time, please, because we're going back there next month. I just came here to let you people know that we're going back there. If you miss healing party, I'm sorry for you. I apologize. Also, the live streaming will not be available after. It will only be available while we are live.
after we are done being like, we will take it down. Okay, that's all I have to say for that too. All right, see you on Thursday. We begin Romans chapter 1. Have you been blessed? Make sure you share on your page. Just let's get the word out. Many people need this. Many people need this experience. This night, some people got delivered this night. Major deliverance just from sharing the gospel. God bless you. Have an amazing night. Love you so much.